13 Sentinels Aegis Rim is a video game for the PlayStation 4 developed by Vanillaware and published by Atlus. Actually, I don't really know whether this is a visual novel with some interactive and gameplay elements, or if this is a legitimate video game, but honestly, I couldn't care less. The point is, it is amazing, and I had such a great time with it after playing it recently, and considering how relatively underappreciated it seems to be, I felt basically obligated to get the word out a little bit to hopefully convince a few of you to give it a try, whether you were on the fence or maybe in case you hadn't even heard of this. 13 Sentinels is an extremely story-centric game with many branching paths that is told in a very non-linear way, but the magic is that regardless of how you choose to progress the story, everything feels very natural. There are three modes within. First is Destruction, which is essentially the gameplay portion that takes place in a period of time far removed from most of the rest of the story. Next is Remembrance, which is the bulk of the narrative that consists of a large series of scenes presented through the perspectives of one of the 13 protagonists and told in an order that is far from chronological. And last is Analysis Mode, which provides character bios, item descriptions, elaborations on plot details in chronological order this time, and more to assist the player with piecing things together as they go. And these modes merge together so seamlessly that it's incredible. I played through in a completely random way, totally based off of my whims and which characters I wanted to see more of, and the story progressed so organically that I can't believe that my path wasn't the only one. Every player will have a different and unique experience because there is nearly complete freedom with how you progress the story, minus a few restrictions here and there. Yet, my path felt like the intended one, even though I know that it wasn't. It's insane. And while that was one of the things that struck me most about 13 Sentinels, there is much more to it. It has great music and voice acting, an awesome and likable cast with a surprising amount of resonance and depth that's really efficiently presented, an absolutely wild plot, just an all-around extremely satisfying and well-crafted story that stimulated my mind and emotions constantly. Every character and their plotline adds variance and freshness and a new dimension to the story, some of the characters being quite lighthearted, some of them very tragic and broken, and basically everything in between. The aesthetics are beautiful, and along with the audio direction, it all manages to consistently capture a super immersive atmosphere that I was delighted to get lost in. The gameplay won't be to everyone's taste, but I enjoyed it quite a bit and found it pretty satisfying. But yeah, you're definitely playing 13 Sentinels for the story, not the gameplay. Yet in spite of that, I was so riveted whilst playing. The game is pretty challenging in the way the story is structured, which requires the player to invest a lot of energy into reflecting and paying attention, but I hardly even noticed because it's something I would have done anyway because of how interesting the story was. That sort of thing sounds like a bit of a cop-out, but it really is the truth here. Concepts like time travel, alternate dimensions, the nuances of memories, time loops, war, and much more. There's an intimidating amount of stuff to grasp here, but for me it never felt intimidating because I naturally wanted to learn and explore this to the fullest. I can't dive into the specifics without spoiling anything since this video is essentially a simple recommendation, but one aspect that really struck a chord with me was that the game has a strong focus on the importance of history and ever-evolving culture and how our pasts are so influential in who we become, while also acknowledging that we are ever-changing. This is accentuated by a very self-aware fixation on anime, sci-fi, and JRPG tropes. In 13 Sentinels, you will see some sort of trope every half hour of game time or so, and while I found that a little bit annoying at first and was kind of disillusioned with it at the start, I quickly realized that it was a very meta and self-aware way of celebrating and conveying this theme of memetics and culture, which turned it from being a bit of an irritant into something quite charming. This game is a celebration of both Western and Eastern storytelling, and it always fixates on that influence, both in-universe and through flashing a wink at the player. It never lets us forget both the ways in which it itself came to be, and the ways the characters have come to find themselves in these situations. And to that effect, if we hone in on the context of the story itself, it's got this ever-present emphasis on nostalgia and sentiment, which producer Akiyasu Yamamoto has said was a main focus of their approach to the background art. These characters go through so many strange and heartbreaking things, but way more often than not are grounded through this sense of longing for an abstract home. Whether that home be a place, a person, a feeling, a period of time, or maybe just peace in general, some characters are so warped by this yearning that they do unspeakable things, and some use this concept as a simple source of peace and comfort and identity. But no matter the context, it was an idea that I connected with so much. It's not a very complicated story, but the presentation and plot structure is where the magic and confusion happens. With so many different character perspectives and so many motivations all intermingling, lines get blurred, and it becomes a bit difficult to keep allegiances in check and to conceptualize where all of these characters came from, how they met one another, and what their dynamics are. But it all slowly comes together in an extremely satisfying way, all the while being grounded by this lovely sense of sentiment throughout that really acts as a source of comfort and peace. The only things that I'll say were notable negatives in 13 Sentinels were that certain relationship dynamics left a bit too much to implication and didn't really feel totally fleshed out, and that there was clearly some cut content leading to threads being underbaked or not even utilized, which was disappointing. There are plot details that I kinda have to forget about or ignore because they just weren't followed through with, which is a bit of an annoying what-if situation. Overall though, 13 Sentinels Aegis Rim is definitely a new favorite of mine. The plot is brilliantly layered, structured, and executed, and the story flow is so natural and effective. There's charm in spades, and it knows when to be very serious and very silly. It's got tons of heart that eventually reveals itself, and so much intelligence in general. I thoroughly loved it, and I keep thinking about it, and it's one of those video game experiences that I will never quite forget. If you have a PS4, and if any of what I said connected with you, and if you're up for a story that is quite bold and challenging and unorthodox yet somehow still very traditional, give it a go, and hopefully you'll find that you like it. If you get half as much out of it as I did, then you're in for a hell of a great time. Many thanks for watching.